This paper pertains. This study integrates forecasting and linear programming issues as well as net present value issues. And the integrated model is capable of determining the optimal production at each factory and the optimal distribution quantities from each factory to each demand center. The first step in the operational design phase of the integrated model is forecasting all the returns for all the products for each factory and for each time period. We must also forecast all the cost components associated with all the products for each factory and for each time period. After that, we can find the difference between the returns and costs, and we can compute the net present value of the forecasted profits by projecting the cash flows to the present time by using a suitable discount rate. We must also forecast the right-hand size of the resource constraints. We must also forecast the unit transportation costs for all the products that are shipped from various factories to various demand centers. And after the forecasting procedure, we use the net present value model, and we get the final transportation cost coefficients. And we would use these coefficients in the minimization segment of the objective function. Basically, we have to multiply the minimization part by -1 and combine it with the maximization of the profits, the profit component. So basically, we integrate those minimization segments and maximization segments under one objective, which is maximization objective. We multiply by -1, we multiply the transportation segment, transportation cost segment by -1, because minimum Z is the same as maximum minus C, where Z is the objective function. Later on, we continue with the constraints after we complete the objective function. We must develop resource availability constraints, then we must develop supply constraints, and eventually the demand constraints are developed. As can be seen, the objective function has two components. The first part is the profit segment, and the second part is the transportation cost segment. And as you can see, transportation cost segment was multiplied by -1 to integrate it into the maximization format. And objective function is followed by constraints, and the first set of constraints is the resource availability constraints. We cannot exceed the amounts of the resources available. The second constraint set shows that the amount of a certain product produced should be equal to the shipment amounts of that product from all the factories to all the demand centers. And here, the xi variables are transferred to the left-hand side so that we have a number on the right-hand side, because this is the preferred format for solving the linear program by using LINDO, Linear Interactive Discrete Optimizer package. The third constraint set shows that amount of product I produced at factory J is equal to the amount of shipment of that product from factory J to all the demand centers. Then the final set of constraints are the demand constraints. And as you can see, this paper uses less than or equal to signs for the demand constraints. We don't use equal to signs because we want to meet the demand to the extent that is profitable to do so. So we don't put the artificial restriction where the demand is met, customer demand is met at any cost. As a matter of fact, the classical transportation model has a minimization objective function followed by supply constraints which have less than or equal to signs. And if the demand constraints had also less than or equal to signs, then all of the variable values would turn out to be zero. To prevent that, they use equal signs for the demand constraints, and it is quite artificial. But in case of the integrated model, even if we use less than or equal to signs, the variables, decision variables, would not turn out to be zero because we have an integrated maximization objective. So classical transportation model does not take into consideration the losses that we would incur by not producing and transporting. So when the objective function has a minimization objective, and if all the constraints had less than or equal to signs, that would mean they don't ship anything and minimize the cost. But then you would not be earning any money by not selling. To prevent the variables from getting zero values, classical minimization, transportation minimization model uses artificial restrictions where we meet the demand at any cost. But we don't have that restriction in this integrated model. So it is a superior model. The regression analysis is conducted by using Microsoft Excel. As can be seen in the solution, the coefficient of determination, R square, is very high, and the standard error is very low. So this indicates that regression, linear regression, may be quite suitable here, according to these measures of effectiveness. And by using the parameters indicated in the solution, we can get the forecasting equation of y cap equals a plus bx. The linear regression forecasting equation is presented here, and also the net present value computation issue is explained. Here, the linear regression seems suitable. However, if a higher degree of precision is required, then we can try some other techniques such as double exponential smoothing and so on. And we can compute the standard deviation associated with different forecasting techniques, and we can choose the one with the smallest standard deviation. The integrated model is expanded here for illustration purposes, and this is done for three products, three factories, and three demand centers by using fictitious data, and the objective function part is presented here. In this slide, you see the constraints. As you can see, the model becomes very large very easily. As a matter of fact, with only 1,000 products, 1,000 factories, and 1,000 demand centers, we would have 1 billion, not 1 million, but 1 billion transportation variables in the objective function. And in real life, we have thousands of products, thousands of warehouses or factories, and thousands of demand centers. So it is important to notice that the problem may get very large very quickly. Once we expand the integrated linear program, then we can copy and paste it in the Lindo main screen page, and then we can click on the solve command on the top, and we would get the solution right away. And when the sensitivity analysis prompt appears, we can click yes, and then we can also have the results of the sensitivity analysis right away. As can be seen in the solution, there are optimal production levels for all the products, and there are also optimal shipment quantities. For example, if you look at X sub 232, you see that it is equal to 60. That means we should ship 60 units of product 2 from factory 3 to demand center 2. And the rest of the solution slides shows sensitivity analysis and so on. After getting the initial solution with the YCAP values, we can continue with the analysis of the impact of statistical variations. We can look at two different extreme cases. One of the extreme case, the upper extreme case, is where we have a situation of YCAP plus three standard deviations. So we can update all the relevant coefficients by using YCAP plus 3 sigma instead of just YCAP. And we can resolve the entire integrated model by using Lindo, and we can check the solution to see if the optimal basis changes or if the product mix changes. And we can also try to see what impact it will have on our budget by looking at the objective function value. And also we can set the appropriate strategies accordingly. Then the final and the third solution would be based on YCAP minus 3 sigma. Again, we would update all the relevant coefficients based on y cap minus 3 sigma, and then we could solve the same model with the updated coefficients, and we can check to see if the optimal basis has changed, if the optimal product mix has changed. If there is any change, we can analyze to what extent the changes have occurred, and we can analyze the budgetary impact, and we can set the appropriate strategies accordingly. This paper may be helpful to some researchers in forecasting and production operations management area. Also, this paper may contribute to certain firms operating in production and distribution fields.